if the church can no longer attract young people, it has to be that they're not taking that with sufficient seriousness. Now,
yeah, I think there's a lot to that.
I don't want to externalize the blame. It's like, I know the church is a human organization and all of that, but it's still evidence.
When I was coming of age, so back in, like, say, the 1970s, the presumption of the church was, we should make this thing as easy as possible, because if we make it hard, these people are going to run away. So we want to make it intellectually easy. So I got a very dumbed down Catholicism. It was through the grace of God that I discovered later in life the very rich Catholic intellectual tradition. But when I was going through school, including through high school, you know, banners and balloons and collages, and it was a very superficial. We got the clearer impression when I was a kid that English and science and math and all that were serious subjects. Religion was like gym, or it was like, you know, I don't know what else, like art class or something. It was considered not that serious. So we dumbed it down intellectually, and we lessened the moral demand for sure, because we didn't want, I think, people to run away. And then, you know, I'll say it bluntly, rather pathetically, we tried to be as relevant as possible. That was the term from our time.
You know, right. And that's like the uncool guy at the party, man.
Right.
You know, if you have to strive to be relevant, you're not on the cutting edge. That's for sure.
Right. And so there's a study I read some years ago that I thought was very plausible. The conclusion was, what young people find compelling in a mentor figure are the two things. One is that the person knows a lot about the subject that he or she is sharing. And secondly, they're really committed to it. And when the kids sense those two things, that, well, there's a lot to know here, and this guy or this woman, they really believe it. They find that compelling. You don't need, you know, the games of relevance. You don't need to dumb it down. In fact, smarten it up and make it as intellectually challenging and morally challenging as possible. We dropped a lot of practices that were much more common years ago, you know, to kind of draw young people into the challenge of it. So that is a problem, absolutely.
Well, one of the things that I've been so delighted by is my observation that there's a tremendous hunger for serious conversation.
Yeah.
Public hunger for it. And when I have engaged in my lectures, I'm always extending myself to my limits of thought. Like, that's what the lecture is. It's an attempt to go past what I think. And there's absolutely no doubt that everyone in the audience is on board with that. I mean, it was the case when I debated Sam Harris, for example, that discussion, which, you know, was as technically complex as Sam and I could make it. And, you know, and that might not be as philosophically complex as the absolute ideal, but it wasn't dumbed down by any stretch of the imagination. And there's no reason that is, if you spoon feed that material, it catches no one